The art of piracy. When I was a kid, I had a friend named Dimitry. He was the one who introduced me to piracy. You know, in Western countries, piracy is more common. My friend Dimitry knew the ins and outs of acquiring pirate game copies at the age of 10, maybe less. I remember how we played Minecraft through Hamachi, let's be honest, a lot of people did, and World of Warcraft on a private Russian server. And so, I grew up pirating games. Of course, it happened less when I got my first console, which was a Nintendo DS where I played Pokemon Platinum Constant on. And of course, not all my PC games were pirated. I had a legit copy of GTA San Andreas, which I enjoyed the hell out of that time. What I'm trying to say is that I grew up knowing a lot about pirating video games and what YouTube tutorials or websites to trust. I could know the difference between a torrent download and a direct download, and why on earth you would want a torrent one instead of a direct one in some situations. What I'm trying to go with is that piracy is a skill of itself. Anybody can find free copies on the internet, but many people just turn away from it. I recently messaged my friend how I pre-ordered Cyberpunk and he responded saying that I should have went on a key selling website to get a lower price. I'm like, dude, are you crazy? The reason why I buy video games is to support the developers. If I cared about the price to the point that buying from a key selling website like GTA is an option, then I would rather just go and pirate the game. The money doesn't go at all to the developers in those shady stores. My friend responded with fuck piracy, I got my Gmail hacked like 3 times from it, and that's where it hit me. Not everyone knows how to acquire pirated copies, even with help of the internet right in front of them. Don't even get me started on making a pirated copy yourself. I'm happy for groups like Codex providing piracy as an option, because in my opinion, piracy should always be an option. It's a way to tell the large companies what they're offering is bullshit. Also, back in my day, I remember enjoying Spiderman 3 on PC a lot. I had the game on a CD drive and then it got scratched. And because of the contract, Spider-Man 3 was pulled from the digital stores, so there were only pirated copies left. It felt so good playing the game again. It's a very old game, yes, but nostalgia is a powerful thing. I'm not saying hell yeah, let's go pirate everything. I'm just saying that there are stupid people out in this world who don't know how to pirate video games. LOL.